don't know, she looks like she's crying.
That looks like her eyes are leaking out of her head.
It does look like her eyes are leaking out of her head. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you guys are new, welcome to the family. My name is Dina. I am so happy to have you guys here. Today I have a special guest with me, my boyfriend Ian. He is gonna help me do a review and walkthrough of the new tarot deck, the Dungeons & Dragons one. Now I do not know much about Dungeons & Dragons, but Ian does because he's played the game with his friends before, so that is why he is here, whereas I have a little bit more of the tarot expertise. So we thought we'd bring the two worlds together just to give you guys a really good overview of the deck. Okay, so when you first get the deck, it looks like this. It does have a very thin layer of plastic on it, but we couldn't wait. We were really excited and we dug into this deck ahead of time. I have to say though, I am happy that I did that because the deck does have some similarities to the Rider Waite Smith, but also a lot of differences. So it'll be very helpful to give you guys a clear idea of what to expect. So the box opens like this. It's very nice, very sturdy. This is what the book looks like. There you go. So it is a 78 card deck, so you do have all the standard major and minor arcana cards. Now the book does have a good amount of information in it. It's nice, it's in full color. Now the thing I do really like about this book is it does give you a little bit of a, almost like a way to incorporate the cards into a Dungeons & Dragons game.
Way to fully incorporate it into your campaigns.
Yeah, it's really cool. So like for example, like the Fool, it says you encounter a gnome who says that if you follow him, he'll lead you to a wondrous treasure. So I'm kind of thinking that you would probably just shuffle the deck and pull a card and then that's the one that you incorporate to your game.
I personally think it'll be really good for one-shot campaigns to give you a little bit of spice into a predetermined idea.
The one thing that we did notice though, we thought was maybe a little bit of a downside, is it doesn't really give you much information in terms of the imagery used in the card. So if you're someone who doesn't know much about the characters in Dungeons & Dragons, it's not going to give you much information except the really simple basic explanation of what the card means. I don't know if they're gonna maybe make a larger book companion in the future. I think that would be definitely a really good added benefit to kind of work with the deck, but that is why we have Ian here. So if you want to know a little bit about Dungeons & Dragons, then hopefully this video will kind of give you a better idea. But anyways, let's move on to the deck. So it has this nice little ribbon flap, which I love when they have these because it makes it easier to pull the deck out. And apparently my hair is already in the deck, like it is in everything. Oops, I've only like opened it like twice too. We've got this little plastic thing here just to keep the cards nice. And I apologize if my birds get loud during this video. There's not really anything I can do about that. Okay, so the first thing I noticed when I first touched these cards is how nice they are. They are very like thick material and they've got this almost, I don't know how to explain it.
They're textured.
They're textured. They feel nice.
They feel leather. Like playing cards.
Yeah.
Like your traditional playing cards, just a little bit thicker.
Yeah, so they're really nice. And if you have the Tarot of the Divine deck, it's actually the same publisher, so the box is the same, and the cards feel the exact same too. So that'll just kind of give you a reference if you do have that deck. So let's actually go through the majors first, and then we'll go into the minors, because there are some details I want to kind of tell you about for the minors that are a little bit different to a standard tarot deck, basically. All right, so first we've got the Fool here. And I think you said he's a bard?
That's a bard. That is definitely a bard.
So it's the guy that like sings the song in the...
Yeah. They use a lot of inspirational magic that's based on their charisma, which is a very cool way to portray
them. I think it's a pretty good portrayal of the Fool. Then we got the magician here. I like the book and everything. The High Priestess is really pretty. I do really like these colors in this. That's one thing we really liked about this deck. The moment we opened it, the art was just gorgeous. And I honestly, I didn't know what to expect because there weren't any pictures really other than the box when we pre-ordered this deck. It surpassed my expectations, I have to say. The Empress is really nice too. We've got the Emperor. Oh yeah, is he like...
A dwarf.
A dwarf, right? Okay. Because I was like, his chair is quite large. But so we got a dwarf.
He's just quite small.
Yeah. Got the Hierophant. Very cool. The Lovers. It looks like one of them at least is an elf.
Yep.
From what we see here. The Chariot. And we still have like the cart Elise. It's not being pulled by anything. Like there's no horses or anything that I can see unless they're not in the frame of the picture. Strength card is quite creepy, but it's cool. I have to say, I like the monster. And what is this monster again? Ian?
Very likely an orc.
Yeah, you know, he looks a little bit like that movie that we watched. Wasn't there like a movie with orcs with like Will Smith or something?
Different magic realm, so to speak, but that was bright.
And then we got the hermit here. Very cool. I love the vibe. Wheel of Fortune. We have a lot of different symbols. Some of them I'm not fully sure what they are. We do have some like elemental symbols here.
I like that card personally because the red dragons are known for being evil aligned dragons.
Okay. Justice. Ooh, yeah, the hangman. I've never seen a hangman with almost like a mirror picture. You've always just had the one, so it's kind of cool. Death card is cool. I thought this one was like really creepy. I like how her hand is coming out of the picture.
I'm a pretty big fan of that one because it's a tiefling. Tieflings are fun. A tiefling.
A tiefling?
Yes.
Okay. Is that like another type of elf? I don't know.
If my logic and memory is right, it's a humanoid mixed with an elemental.
Oh, that would make sense with the fire, like a fire element. He is Googling.
So they're humans that mixed their bloodline with a powerful, evil, extraplanar being.
Ooh, then we've got Temperance, which is really interesting. There's all these little demons in the mirror. Do you know what those are?
There is a lot of lore, and you're allowed to make your own lore, which is fun.
Yeah. I don't know, my first instinct that comes to me when I look at this card is balancing your inner peace and almost like taming your inner demons. And then we've got the Devil card. I just think he's fabulous. He's like really creepy, but he's just like extra with my glass of looks like blood. It could be wine, but definitely looks like blood to me. But he looks kind of cool. I like his outfit. And then we've got the Tower, and we've got four? Five.
So that is,
five dragons.
If I'm right, that's actually one dragon. It's Tiamat. Mother of Dragons.
Oh, and has five heads?
Yes.
Okay. And we've got the Star. Very much like this card too. It's very pretty. And she's an elf.
So she would be a drow, which is a evil aligned elf that live underground but have a weakness to sunlight. So being under starlight would make sense.
Oh. And then we've got the moon. So she's kind of holding a moon. And then we've got some sort of creature skeleton. Maybe like a dragon skeleton or something? I don't actually know.
So they could be a necromancer or they could be a warlock making a deal with a demon.
Ooh, the sun. I love the art. I just love the reflection of the setting sun on everything. It's just really, really pretty.
It's a very vibrant card while remaining in muted tones. I like it.
Yeah. Did it say what the artist is? I feel like that's something we should mention. Illustrator, Fred Gisabel. I don't know if I'm saying that right. The writer is Adam Lee. Designer, Nicole Bois. Judgment. So that's, we have the typical angel in the background, but...
That one's definitely a paladin.
Okay.
So they're warrior priests, generally of good alignment. They're also lawful. So there's a scale in Dungeons & Dragons. Good, yeah. Neutral, evil, chaotic,
right.
Lawful.
That makes sense with the Judgment card then.
Yes.
That's cool. You can see obviously everything, every character that they chose is very thought out for sure. And then the World card, they've got their drinks, they've got their gold.
The stereotypical open for Dungeons & Dragons is all the player characters would meet in a tavern and that would be how the adventure starts. I like that one because it is the world, so it's showing them at the start and possibly at the end of their journey with their gold and
right.
Rewards.
Okay, that would make sense. All right, so that's the Major Arcana. So we're gonna break up the Minor Arcana into separate piles just so you guys get a clear idea, because they didn't choose to do the typical wands, cups, swords, pentacles. They actually made their own categories. The one thing that I find is really confusing is they don't write which one's which on the cards. This is gonna be a deck that I have to study. It's a little confusing because some of them I was thinking, okay, this might be their version of the swords, but then I'd see other cards from other categories with so many swords. So it was a little bit confusing. So they said that they did map the traditional suits of the Minor Arcana. However, they chose to do their own version of that. So they have strength, intelligence, wisdom, and charisma, which once we actually read the description of each one, we realized the strength is associated with the wands, because if you look at the descriptors, there's like passion, creativity, and then intelligence, we see keywords as in they use their thoughts to shape their attitudes. So that makes sense that it would be tied to the swords then. And then wisdom, they have its nonverbal language of the heart and the body. So that's definitely cups because it's very, you know, heart-centered, emotional. And then charisma found that it said their ability to influence the material world with their energy. So material world, we think pentacles. So this is wands, swords, cups, pentacles. So we have the ace of wands here.
Ace of strength,
which if you wanted to compare it to the Rider Waite Smith would be wands.
That guy is definitely a monk, which is unarmed and unarmored class in Dungeons and Dragons.
So then we have number two here. And yeah, very different than the Rider Waite imagery. So I have to say it's not what I would expect, but cool card to look at nonetheless. We got number three here. Now the four of strength, this one definitely makes sense to me in terms of relating to the four of wands in the Rider Waite, just basically having that support system. And then we have number five here, which if you guys are familiar with Rider Waite, that's usually the card where everyone's kind of fighting with wands. So I thought that was really interesting that this card came up, but then when I read the book, they were like, they're choosing to work together instead of fight against each other. Yeah, it was an interesting take on it. And we got the six, which is the victory card, which makes sense with this picture.
Yep. Yeah. We also have a human and elf and a tiefling again.
Seven, he's fighting off some monsters of some sort.
No clue what they are.
It doesn't look like they have eyes. They kind of look like the aliens from Alien. The little baby ones.
I just like that he's still holding a chicken leg.
I know. It looks like he's either beating the monster with the chicken leg or he's really trying hard to save it because he's like, that's my dinner for later, you know?
Definitely both.
Then we got number eight here. It looks like they're venturing off somewhere. Number nine. And then we've got number 10. He's got a bunch of little gremlins.
Goblins
on his back. Paige is that a goblin?
Yep.
Okay. I don't know if I trust him. I don't trust him to cook my food. He looks like he's up to something. Just saying. The knight. This is the one that we're just laughing so hard because it looks like Mike Wazowski. Mike Wazowski makes a few appearances in this deck. And then we have the queen. I love the queen card. She's pretty awesome.
Definitely.
And she's got some fire, so it's tying in the fire element. So there's little hints here and there sometimes, for some of the cards at least, what suit you belong to.
I was gonna say, she'll be a spellcaster, whether that's a warlock or a wizard or something else that I completely forget right now. Not too sure.
Okay. And then we've got the king. This one confused us a little bit because we're like, there's a sword though. He's interesting. Okay, so the next one is intelligence, which would be the swords and the Rider Waite Smith. And we've got the ace here.
Definitely not at all a wizard. At all.
Yeah, I think that's one that any of us could maybe figure out. It's neat. You definitely have some rune stones or rune symbols here anyways. Very cool card. I like that one. Then we got the two. And this one, I was trying to look at all the other cards. I'm like, is this just the art style? Because it looks like he has no eyes. But it would make sense for him to not have eyes for like the two of intelligence, two of swords, because this is the card where she's holding the two swords and her eyes are covered with a thing. A rope, not a rope. Blindfold is the word I'm looking for. And we got number three. I think this card is so cool. She's kind of creepy, but she's really, really cool.
I thought she was a druid at first, and I actually have no clue. So druids are generally forest magic.
Well, that would make sense, though, with the mushrooms and the sticks out of her hair and all that stuff. This is the card in the Rider Waite Smith where we usually have the heart with a sword stabbed through them. So, I don't know, she looks like she's crying, so it looks like some sort of...
That looks like her eyes are leaking out of her head.
It does look like her eyes are leaking.
I would be crying too.
Yeah, me too. Doesn't sound pleasant. Then we got the four of intelligence. So it looks like they're all contemplating, taking a break from their journey.
I would assume that's in representation of a short rest or a long rest, which in Dungeons & Dragons resets your health or resets talents so that you can continue using them. They really help people a lot. Otherwise, you'd run out of magical spells or abilities by the end of the dungeon that you're going through.
Ah.
Or adventure.
That makes sense. And very much in line with the four swords, so that's cool. Then we got five. And it looks like they're
holding a vase.
Fighting or pulling apart a vase. And we've got the six here. It's kind of cool.
This one looks like somebody going through a portal.
It does, right?
Which is very prominent in Dungeons & Dragons because there's multiple realms to go through.
We got the seven. He's got a mask on, which seven of swords got to mean like you're deceiving someone or maybe even deceiving yourself.
Could be a rogue or a quest giver.
Mm. quest giver.
I'm just using that as a phrase because there's NPCs that would give you quests in the campaign to do, like save the child who fell down the well, or go kill 10 wolves and bring back their pelts.
That's pleasant. 8 of intelligence very much matches the 8 of swords, being tied up with all the swords around them, so.
So that card there looks like the character Drizzt Do'Urden, which is a drow elf that has many books about him. He's good aligned instead of evil aligned, and repeatedly clashes with the regular drow and their god. And their goddess of spiders, or goddess of spiders.
Oh, so that's totally a spider web.
Yeah, I'm totally spacing on their name right now, but there's actually like a hybrid creature that is a giant spider mixed with a drow that is heavily used by them as well, that he repeatedly comes in conflict with.
Thanks for that. That makes sense. Oh my god. Oh, is that?
You can see the legs too.
Those are spider legs. I just got closer and I saw the hair and I realized that those aren't just swords. Oh, that is terrifying. That is a card of my nightmares. Like, I've actually had dreams of giant spiders. Okay. 9 of intelligence. This one's creepy too. Like, look at that squid thing and something alien.
The squid thing is a mind flayer, also called a lithid.
Okay.
And they actually straight up like drink people's brains.
Ooh.
They're also a species of the Underdark, which is where the drow live. Looks like she's trying to stop it from doing its thing.
Doing its thing.
If I remember correctly, don't use so much magic as psionics, which is psychic abilities instead of magic.
And then we've got the 10 of intelligence. And then we've got the page, and she's got a little dragon. This one's very steampunky.
It is. So that one makes me think of the Artificer class. I don't know a lot about that class personally, other than a lot of people online were complaining about how overpowered it was. Which makes it sound great to me.
Yeah. All right. And then we have the Knight of Intelligence. That looks like...
a hammer?
Yeah, it is a hammer. No, but it looks like Thor's.
Mjolnir.
Okay.
So that is, I'm assuming he's a paladin again, because sun imagery is very popular with paladin characters, and hammers are also very popular.
Okay. We got the queen.
Who's definitely not evil at all.
She definitely has black eyes. She looks so creepy, but she's kind of cool. Her spiky headgear reminds me of Hexadecimal from Reboot. Any 90s kids out there know what I'm talking about? I'm such a nerd, but I loved that show as a kid. And the king. This is definitely like mythology, right? This looks like Hercules and his dad.
Seems there's jellyfish. Yeah. Likely not Zeus. Okay. Seeing as he's not a part of D&D, but a god of the sea, very likely.
Okay.
There are lots of gods in Dungeons & Dragons. Could not even name even a portion of them.
All right, so this one is the suit of wisdom, which aligns with the suit of cups in the Rider Waite Smith. This guy looks kind of interesting.
I'll give you 3 guesses what he is. We talked about it earlier.
Oh, shit, we did. Well, he's got tree legs. I don't actually remember.
Definitely a druid.
Oh, druid! Yeah, that makes sense. Okay. Looks like there's a bear coming out of his back.
My interpretation wouldn't be that he actually has a bear coming out of his back or tree legs. It would be him channeling nature through him. It's a representation of the magic that he's using and channeling through himself. Mm. In my mind, that's how I see it.
You're so deep.
The roots.
We got the 2.
With a dead Mike Wazowski behind them.
Oh my god, I didn't even notice that one.
A beholder.
A beholder. The Mike Wazowski thing?
The Mike Wazowski in this picture is very likely a beholder.
Okay.
See how he has the like tentacly things coming off the top of his head.
This guy's got an egg. Do they lay eggs?
No, beholders actually hate each other. Dream new young ones into existence.
That's interesting. And then we've got the 3, which is very 3 of cups. Like, you've got the 3 people just like celebrating together and just loving life.
Celebrating your simpleness.
Celebrating. Well, that's what the imagery looks like. It's very much the same imagery as the Rider Waite Smith. And we got a little gnome?
Yes, a gnome, and it looks like a fennec fox.
Oh, right.
Fennec foxes are actually a real thing, and they're adorable.
That's so cute. 5. He looks kind of terrifying.
I'm assuming he's an ogre, or because they're just really tiny gnome-looking peoples, it might just be a regular-sized orc.
Okay, fair enough. And then we've got the 6 of wisdom. It looks like he's imagining things based on what he's reading in his book.
That one makes me think of a young kid getting into Dungeons & Dragons with this being the player manual and that being the world that he's imagining.
That could very much be that. Yeah, that's really cool. Yeah. It's interesting because the Rider Waite, the 6 of cups, is basically reminiscing. thinking about things from the past or your childhood and stuff. So it's kind of cool that they have a kid like playing.
It could also be a young nobleborn who is reading about the heroics of adventurers.
Mm.
Also a very cool concept.
Yeah, I like it. 7. And I did see this one at first and he had it pointed out to me, but this is totally the scary fish from Finding Nemo.
It very much looks like an anglerfish or some underdark monster that works like an anglerfish.
Yeah, I was like looking at it, I'm like, oh, the pretty glowy thing. And Ian's like, yeah, you're not seeing the bigger picture here, Dean. I'm like, oh, I would totally get eaten.
You would have died just like he is.
I don't know, like maybe you shouldn't use this deck right before bedtime. It might give you some nightmares, but it's pretty cool. We got the 8 here.
So we spoke about this character earlier.
Oh, did we?
So this again looks like Drid Stoarden.
Oh.
The good aligned drow. He actually is a ranger, so that's another very close to nature class. They can have like animal partners. He has one. It's a panther.
Okay.
Also looks like he's deflecting an attack with a shield.
Yeah, and then we've got 9 here. Looks like he's all happy and he's...
There's a rat chewing on his chair.
Oh, that is a huge rat.
He's relaxing and he's about to have an unfortunate accident into the fire behind him.
And then we've got the 10. That's a pretty cool looking dragon thing. It looks very skinny though. Skinny like a snake.
I'm pretty sure there are flying snake mobs in the game.
Oh. The page. Knight. It's a very knightish card.
Yep. Reminds me of Roman legionnaires.
Roman legionnaires.
That's a real thing from history.
Oh. I'm not good at history. I love this card. This is one of my favorite cards. It's very pretty. And I like how they have the water. It makes it a lot easier for me to identify the card. It's very Ariel-like too with her
red hair.
Red hair, yeah. She might be an elf though, because she's got like pointy ear there.
Yes, she is an elf.
And then we've got the king. All right, so this one is charisma and it is matched to the pentacles kind of the Rider Waite Smith.
Definitely a dwarf.
Yeah.
Definitely has a sword.
They like to give a lot of the characters like white or black eyes.
Yes.
It's very interesting. Looks like she's casually fighting off a demon.
My assumption is that she's actually a tiefling warlock summoning a familiar.
Oh, a familiar. That's fun.
Yeah.
Cool. And then we've got the 3 having a good time.
Fighting the
tentacles. Fighting together, yeah. Well, he's playing music, but I guess that's how he fights.
Using like inspiration or something to get his teammates better rolls or better stats.
Right. The 3 of Pentacles is a very collaborative card, so it's kind of cool that they chose that.
If I was fighting a giant octopus thing with spiky tentacles, I would not be doing it on my own.
Yeah. This one's cool. We got the dragon guarding the gold, which is very much like the Rider Waite Smith when the guy has like the coins and he's holding them tight. We got the 5 here. He looks very sad. What is that thing? He looks like a mixture of like a dragon and an armadillo.
So you have the big dragon with all the gold and you have a little dragon with no gold.
Oh yeah, true. This is the card in the Rider Waite Smith where the people are outside of the church and they're poor and they're all sad. So
yeah.
It's very fitting. And then we've got the 6. Looks like he's raining coins.
Probably a tavern picture again.
Yeah.
Or a gambling den. To me, it feels like the person you and your characters would walk up to interact with, in my mind at least, because you're facing somebody who looks well-established, not like somebody who travels, and then I'm not saying the people around him look evil, but they don't look good.
Okay.
So I'm assuming he'd be like the main antagonist or somebody you'd have to outsmart or fight or something to get further in the campaign.
Right, right. Cool. We got the 7 of charisma. Looks like he's picking some sort of fruit or something. I like this one. This one makes very much a lot of sense. And her hair is freaking awesome.
I say I really like her hair.
It's really cool. You need to braid my hair like that for me because I can't do it.
Okay. Good luck. I don't know if you'll survive.
You'll survive. It's really cool. But this is very fitting because the 8 of Pentacles in the Rider Waite Smith is the like work card and they have the hammer and their pentacles and stuff.
To me it looks like she's making an enchanted weapon because her hammer has flames either coming off it or behind it. So to me I feel like she's channeling magic through the hammer into the sword.
Very cool. And we've got the 9 here. Looking pretty victorious.
And pirate-y.
Yeah, and pirate-y.
Mostly pirate-y.
We've got the 10. They're just like so happy living their best life. He's just like, I've got a beautiful elf wife and I've got an apple tree.
They're both definitely gnomes.
I'm sorry. That is so offensive to them. I'm a gnome and I have a beautiful wife and an apple tree.
Just gonna counter that with like she looked astronomically younger than him too, so it could be his daughter. I was gonna say he's a druid teaching a younger druid because he's growing the plants around him. He has the bear behind him, but it doesn't look violent. It looks like it's just following.
Yeah.
It's very like nature filled card.
Oh, for sure. We got the page. I like this. This is giving me
strong ranger vibes for me. Because it's a person with their animal companion.
I'm thinking of Aladdin, Princess Jasmine, and her tiger pet.
Raja.
Raja, that's the name. Thank you.
Yeah, I'd assume this is them going to the boss room of a dungeon.
Mm.
Or to get the reward for completing a quest for, like, a kingdom. Because that door is just really fancy and worth more than my house.
I'd say maybe setting forth to do the journey, if I'm comparing it to the page. Because the page is usually at the beginning of the journey, whereas the king's kind of more
at the
end. Okay, so they're
leaving the palace.
But quite possibly, yeah. And then Mike Wazowski comes in again.
RoboCop, like, Mike Wazowski.
RoboCop.
That would be like one of the cool, fun characters that the DM would make for people to meet as they go into a bar. That would be the bartender.
Oh, okay. We got the queen. She's got an interesting family at the table there. This girl's really, really small. She's
probably a halfling, which is kind of like a hobbit from Lord of the Rings.
Mm. Okay.
Like a little bit bigger than a gnome, but not quite. Cool. I think it's them stopping in at a tavern and having a long rest, so to speak, to gain all their stats back before they do the main portion of the adventure or the heavy fighting portion of the adventure.
Makes sense. They've got time for pie.
There's always time for pie.
And then we've got the king.
The bardiest of bards.
The bardiest of bards. He's got some, like, cool hair there.
Yeah.
That's like an interesting.
Yeah, he's a level 20 bard.
Level 20?
Level 20 being the maximum level that you can achieve in the game.
Mm. How do you know he's level 20? Because he's got awesome
fancy
hair.
Fancy AF.
Anyways, guys, that is the Dungeons & Dragons tarot deck. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope it gave you a little bit of a clear idea what this deck is all about from a tarot, but also Dungeons & Dragons standpoint. Thank you so much for joining me. I appreciate it. Overall, I really enjoyed the deck. I think it's very beautiful. It definitely exceeded my expectations, so I'm very happy with it. The only thing I have to say is some of the cards are a little hard to distinguish, so it's definitely going to take a lot of research and work on my part to really get to know the deck, but overall, I'm very satisfied with it. I hope you guys have a beautiful day or night whenever you're watching this, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye, guys.